Just getting some gas here. My CBI 1000 double R. Damn, baby. Looking good, man. Sorry about that. But anyways, top five worthless motorcycle stuff.
Let's go for a ride.
You are watching Cycle Cruises all on one motorcycle channel. Subscribe today.
Yeah, guys, I've had a bunch of different motorcycle stuff through the years. I've been motor vlogging. I've had this channel since 2012, guys. I've had a ton of stuff. I've got over 1,200 videos. You guys have, if you go to my website, you know, cyclecruiser.com, I got links to all my gear, all my stuff, everything. Like I said, I've had so much motorcycle stuff over the years that I have not done videos on most of the stuff, because if it was junk, I felt like I didn't want to waste my time doing a video on it. You know what I'm saying? Just to say, hey guys, this is junk. I know you guys would probably appreciate that, but I just didn't feel like it was worth my time to do videos on stuff that's junk. So I just thought I'd do this top five video of worthless motorcycle junk. But anyways, number one on the list is aftermarket headlight housings. For, you know, for those of you guys that want to turn your bike into a street fighter, or for those of you who have a dual sport, or if you got dirt bikes, you know, they sell all those different type of aftermarket headlight housings, which I just bought one for my WR250R, and it's pretty good. It's probably the best one that I've had in a long time. All of the other ones were junk. I tell you guys, I've wasted my money on so many of those headlight housings trying to make my WR250R look better. And I tell you, those headlights aren't worth, they ain't even worth being made. I don't even know why they even made those, a lot of those junk headlights, man. Headlight housings, should I say. But I'll tell you guys that, don't waste it. Be careful on that, man. I wish I'd have kept them and did videos on them for you guys to show you how junky they were. A lot of them, you can adjust the headlight beam properly. This one I just bought, that Acerbis headlight that I have for my WR250R, that one you can adjust the, you can adjust the beam on it. It's pretty good. I like that one so far. That's why I decided I did a video on it. You know, I mentioned it for you guys to get in the video when I did the unveiling. Woo! Love that rocket blast, baby! Yeah! CBI 1000 double R, baby! For life! But anyways, number two on the list is those, for the dual sport and dirt bikes, those shorty breather tubes. I tell you guys, don't waste your time buying the shorty breather tube that goes on, you know, the tank cap, gas tank cap, so you don't have to put one of those vent lines in. That's why I got it. I thought it looked cooler, and also it was just cool because I could just take the cap off without having to, you know, pull the gas vent line out of the triple tree hole or whatnot. But I'll tell you guys, every one of those that I've bought had popped off. Every single one. I've had them all, guys, all of them. So don't waste your money on those stupid breather tubes. Now I know a lot of you street bike riders could care less because you don't use that for your bike. But that takes me to the next piece of junk, worthless motorcycle item that some of you guys do buy, are the aftermarket tank caps. I'll tell you guys that those cheaper ones, don't waste your money on them cheap Chinese ones, man. Yeah, they look cool and everything, but you know what? They do not seal properly, and it releases fumes from the gas tank, and you'll also lose fuel efficiency because the tank cap is not sealing properly. Yeah, I bought one of those, a couple of them in the past for the CBR 600RR because it matched my my fairings and everything. I thought it looked really cool. And man, my fuel efficiency went down. My gas, my garage smelled like gas. It's just a piece of junk, man. But anyways, number four. A lithium battery ion charger, you know, for the motorcycle lithium ion batteries, like the one, you know, I just bought one, which, by the way, if you haven't seen that video review I did on it, go check it out. I'll include a video link in the description and comment section of this video. It's the anti-gravity restart smart lithium ion battery, which is super lightweight, weighs like a pound, 1.32 pounds, and it has that. It has technology so that if the battery, it detects that the battery is going low, it will shut it off, but it'll leave enough power so you can press the restart button on the top. So, but anyways, awesome battery. So far, I haven't had any issues, but, you know, I've rocked a lithium-ion battery for some time now. I had a ballistic battery on my WR250R in the past, which is going to be put in this bike, the CBR1000RR, when I get a chance. But I tell you, you don't need the lithium ion battery charger, because these lithium ion batteries hold their charge so well. I've never had to use it. It collects dust in the garage, man. And I've had my bike sit for, my WR250R has sat for, what, since May? April or May or whatever, because I was modding the bike. And I'll tell you guys, I did not have the lithium ion battery charger hooked up to it at all. And the battery stayed, it kept the 3.1 or 3.2 volts. They hold their charge so well that you really don't need it. But if you are going to use a charger, and you have to use a charger, use a lithium ion battery charger. So, yes, it is useful if you need it, but if you need it, most likely it's because the battery has degraded and you probably need to replace it anyhow. You know what I'm saying? Because these lithium ion batteries, they should hold their charge. They're rated to hold their charge for a long time, as long as there's no parasitic draw being drawn from the battery. So, you know, like a motorcycle alarm or anything that's drawing any, you know, small amounts of power from it. So you don't really, in my opinion, you don't need it. It's a waste of money. And those chargers can be very expensive. That ballistic lithium ion battery charger, I think like $100 and something I paid for that. And it's like I said, I've never used it. I never had to. Number five that is really worthless is a cheap motorcycle gear. You know, don't waste your money on cheap gear at all. It's a waste, guys. Don't get one of them jackets like I had back in the day when I was riding my Chinese scooter being cheap, and that old $50 motorcycle jacket with no seat armor. It has no padding, nothing. I went down on that Chinese scooter because of those crappy wheels and rain. And man, I got a road rash on my arm through the jacket. That's how crappy it was. And don't waste your money on cheap motorcycle helmets. They fog up, they don't fit right, and they probably don't protect your head that well. They probably just got a cheap foam inside and made of cheap materials. Don't waste your money on cheap gear, guys. That's worthless, absolutely worthless junk. If you're gonna wear gear, get proper gear. You know, like I said, the CD boots. I just bought some CD Cobra boots, my last CD Fusion Air boots. Had freaking, I got 5 years out of those suckers. And then I've had cheap boots in the past where they didn't even last freaking, I mean, I never did videos on them because they were absolute junk. They wore out after like a couple of months. It was just junk. Get the best gear and it will last a long time. Don't waste your money on the junk, man. Listen to me now. And I'll tell you guys, the best dual sport helmet I ever had, and I've had a bunch of different ones, is this Suami MX Tour helmet. This helmet is amazing, man. It flows beautiful air, and I'll tell you, no, never fogs up. no matter if I ride off in the woods and breathing heavy. And it's amazing. I love the brim where I can put my camera underneath it. And I love the wide viewing angle with the, I love it, man. And I rock it with both my CBR 1000RR and also my Ducati X-Diablo-S in addition, mainly for my WR250R though. But it's an awesome helmet. It's not cheap, but you pay for what you get. But for those of you guys that want to get my motorcycle gear, my boots, my camo pants, helmet, everything, gloves, I always include links in the description and comment section of my videos, or go to my website at cyclecruiser.com. Click on the menu tab, My Gear, and those are a bunch of links to all of my gear and everything. And for those of you that want to see more of my videos, click on the menu tab, My Videos, and those are a bunch of playlists with over 1,200 plus videos categorized into those playlists. So hopefully you can find something that will inform you, entertain you. Hey, hit thumbs up. It really helps me get motivated to do more videos when you hit thumbs up and you leave comments, guys. That's why I do these videos, to interact with you guys. Don't forget to subscribe to my All of a Motorcycle channel, and also go check out my other channel, Bug Out Moto.
It showcases a van that I customized for cheap that allows me to live in my van with my motorcycle anywhere, and has a ton of cool mods. And that channel has everything from build videos, trip videos, anything and everything Bug Out Moto. As a courtesy, I included two video playlists, one for new riders, and those are all of the videos I've done over the years that I feel are helpful for new riders, and also my popular videos playlist. Hey, hit the subscribe button. I appreciate it. Take care.